parents are still paying at least one of adults' bills for them. That's 3 in 10 adults admit this.
Oh, that's a little low right there.
You know, but it goes down to Robbie and I, my husband and I, are daily fascinated by some of our friends and their spending. Like, how are you buying another trip or car or whatever? And I mean, we're not struggling, but I feel like we couldn't do any of that. And I'm like, do they make just millions and we don't realize it? Or do people live in debt?
Yeah, people live in debt. They don't care. They keep buying.
They need their parents to pay bills. I wonder what kind of bills the parents are paying. Because sometimes you could be, I understand health insurance, because up until age something, you could be on your parents, you know,
into
25
20s,
or something. Yeah.
Right? But I remember I was 29, even 30 years old, needing a little bit of help from a dad. I remember.
I think
moved
that's
back
different.
Home at 29.
Listen,
for a year.
Everybody, I can understand a helping hand, but to regularly pay a bill?
Like a phone bill, car bill, something like that.
Yeah.
My daughter is 20 in college. I still pay her car, and I've only got 2 or 3 more payments until I'm done. Car's just about paid off. But she don't need to be paying that right now. She's going to college. I will help her.
Yeah. No, I consider college.
Yeah, you're still
under
a kid.
The roof. Yeah. Although my husband, I was lucky that my parents paid for college.
Yeah.
And I know that was like a huge gift. Robbie, my husband, didn't have that. So it really made me rethink schooling, because I was like, oh, I thought everybody did. You know, I was so blinded.
No.
By my own situation, I just figured, oh, like, it takes life experience to understand. Not everyone is the same as you, you know?
I do. And by being an orientation advisor and an RA in the dorms, I was able to supplement college. And it wasn't as expensive back then as it is now. My daughter dealing with some of these loans. People are going to be strapped.
Forever. Yeah, my dad said, you have to buy your books and, you know, pay for food and phone and all that when I was in college, and that was enough to send me into spiral. You know, I was like, how am I going to do all that? I can't imagine doing it all.
Yeah.
At that age, I don't think I would have gone. I would have been like, well, it's not for me.
And 410-338-1098, is anybody out there into your 30s and maybe your mom still pays your credit card bill or your phone or insurance for your car?
Yeah. I mean, I guess to each his own. If the parents are cool with it and they've got plenty of money,
yeah,
no big deal.
Lucky.
Or
lucky.
If they have a medical problem, maybe the adult kids are helping the parents. You know, maybe it's some sort of agreement. So I'm sure there's lots of situations.
That's what happens. You're the kid.
Mommy.
And the parents are helping you out. And then the roles reverse, and as they get older, they become the kids, and then you're helping the parents out.
Yeah. Somebody on Twitter was saying in Asian households, it's really common to live with your parents as an adult and sort of help it out, help
Italy
out
too.
Everything.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I guess in this country, it's common for us to move out, and then the elderly are kind of on their own, and we're like, well, good luck in the assisted living home or wherever you're going
to
be.
They get to circle back. The elderly, after you move out, then they move in with you.
Yes.
I remember my mother's brother and mother lived with us when I was a little kid. And they were in the basement, Nana making Uncle Junior food on a hot plate.
Right.
Way back in the bowels of the basement. Well, that was part of the deal. Was when they built this house in Waterbury Heights, they were going to move in.
Uh-huh. Somebody texted, and I swear I pay my parents' bills more than they do, and I pay mine still and have a kid to take care of.
Right?
Yeah, I'm sure there's lots of situations. Ryan from Baltimore, what's up?
Not much. So my mom still buys my clothes.
Hey.
How old are you, Ryan?
I'll be 32 next week, but I do get to pick them out.
What? No, I don't believe you.
Is it online, or are you kidding, or is that legitimate?
Legitimate. She gives me the credit card, and I just go to oldnavy.com, and I'm the Old Navy poster child.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, Ryan, what do you do for a living?
I work for a construction company.
So you have an income. You've got money. Why do you want your mom to pay for it?
It's not that I want her to. It's that she wants to still feel like she's being my mom.
Right.
Aww.
And so it makes her happy and puts a smile on her face. And I make sure it's limited only to Christmas and birthday.
Okay.
Oh, so you only buy clothes a couple times a year?
Pretty much.
Yeah, you're
and
a guy,
that's about the only clothing purchases I get.
And who are you to snatch the joy from your mom? You're putting a smile on her face.
Exactly. If it makes her happy, who am I to argue?
Your old Navy khakis puts a smile on everybody's face.
Way to go, Ryan.
Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you.
That's actually adorable.
You know?
I just want to help my mom.
And mothers feel like they're still parenting. They're still needed. They don't want to be kicked to the curb.
Right, right. Well, they want to. I know my mom would love to pick out all the clothes that we wear, for sure. She has things to say about everything we wear.
I am let you do your thing. You don't have to worry about me telling you what to wear. Yeah.